Hello, and welcome to your Kidspiration Story Map Creation Lesson Number 1. In order to start the program, you need to click on the Start menu, All Programs, and select Kidspiration. You need to click OK, and then click New Picture. It turns green when it's going to be selected. Click one time. Okay. This is the page where we are going to create our main story map. In the center, we're going to create the base for the story map with the title, author, illustrator, and name of the person creating the story map. Click once outside of the box and click right back on it to get those red boxes. Now you can reshape what you just wrote to make it a little bit bigger and easier for future use. Now, while it's still selected with those red boxes around it, you want to click this icon up here. You're going to add a symbol that will be connected automatically to what you just did. The arrow guides it right to where it needs to be. The first thing I want to type in the box is characters. So I click on it one time. I now have the red boxes outside of this character. And I click outside one time. Now I don't want it to be in this part of the story map, so I'm going to drag it around and it's going to go on the top of my story map. I'm also going to make it a little bit bigger. I'm going to click back on the center circle again to select it so I can add another box. This time I'm going to click on it one time and write setting. Again, I'm going to click outside of it. Click right back on it to get those red boxes, and I want this one to be up over here on the other side of the box. And I'm going to make this a little bit bigger as well. I want to click on the center one again so I have the red boxes and I know it's selected. I'm going to add another circle, and this time it's going to say problem because the problem is an important story element. I'm going to drag it. I want it to be on this side. And I want the box to be a little bit bigger, so I'm going to click on it one time, drag the red boxes to make it bigger. Now I'm going to click on the center one again and add the final box to my story map. This one is going to be the solution. Click outside, click on it. I want to move it a little bit out, and I also want to make it a little bit bigger. This is the basic format for my story map. I can continue to change the size of the circles as I wish, if I want them to be a little bit bigger or smaller based on what I want to use the story map for in the future. I can make them all bigger, smaller, whatever works best for me. This looks pretty good, so I'm going to save it. In order to save it, I'm going to click File, Save. Now I want to save it in a place that I'm going to remember where it is. Under My Documents, I will save it as Story Map and click Save. Now I can edit it for a particular story. This is something I can do with students, or I can prepare it ahead of time to show students an example of a final product. For the rest of this story map, I'm going to be creating it with the story Dr. DeSoto by William Steig. So first, I'm going to edit the information in the center circle. I click on it one time and click it one more time to get the cursor. Next to the word title, I'll put a colon and Dr. DeSoto. The author is William Steig, and he is actually the illustrator as well. Now, I'm not going to worry about the spacing just yet. I'll do that in 1 minute. And then put your name at the bottom. If I click outside and back in one time, I get those red squares, and I can adjust the size of my circle. Now all the names are on the same line. Now it's important that I go up to the word characters. This is where I'm going to begin my story map. I click once to select it and click again to get the cursor. After the word characters, I'm going to hit the enter key and I'm going to type the characters. You're Dr. DeSoto, Mrs. DeSoto, and the fox. Okay, I'm going to select out of there because I'm going to be adding stamps now. So the fun part of Kidspiration is that it has all these fantastic stamps on the side that you can add to your story map so that it's more comprehensive for younger students. So the characters are Dr. DeSoto, Mrs. DeSoto, and the fox. Mrs. DeSoto and Dr. DeSoto are mice. So I need to find a mouse. And I look in this set of stamps, and if the picture's kind of small and I can't quite tell what it is, it shows up much larger next to it. I don't have to click on it. I'm just rolling the cursor over the icons. Now that I don't see what I want here, so I'm going to click the blue arrow. Now when I roll over it, it's telling me that the next page has pictures of pets. I'm going to click once, and there are the images of the pets. Just rolling my cursor over them. Oh, perfect, I found a mouse. So I'm going to click on the mouse, keeping my left clicker clicked, and drag it to the location that I want it. Now it is a little bit big, so I'm going to make it a little bit smaller by adjusting those red boxes again. There's Dr. DeSoto. And I need to make sure I deselect the mouse before I go into this toolbar again, because if I click this a new animal, it's going to replace my mouse. So just make sure that those red boxes disappear by clicking once outside of it. And I can click my mouse again, dragging it to be Mrs. DeSoto. Now again, it's a little bit big, so I want to resize it using those boxes and make sure that once it's placed, I click out of it so that I don't accidentally replace it with a different character. Now I need to find a picture of the fox. So I'm going to search through. Oh, perfect, there's a fox. I'm going to click on him and drag him over right there. He's a pretty important character in the story. Now that the characters are complete, I'm ready to move on to the setting. The setting of the story is in the dentist's office. Dr. DeSoto is a dentist. So now I'm going to search for a picture that goes along with my words, dentist's office. There are lots and lots of pictures to choose from, as you can see. Oh. Perfect, and there is a hospital, and I'm going to just use the hospital because it shows that it's a medical building. I don't even need to resize it, it's perfect. I'm ready to move on to the problem. Now the problem in the story is that Dr. DeSoto and his wife are mice. Now the fox eats mice. So the problem is the fox wants to eat Dr. and Mrs. DeSoto. But the mice are too smart for the fox, and they come up with a solution to use glue to glue the fox's mouth shut so he cannot eat the mice. Now I need to add pictures to my problem and solution. Now for the characters in the setting, I typed them and added the pictures right away. The problem and the solution I wrote, and now I'm going to find the pictures. It's up to you and what works best for you, your students, as to whether or not you do it in this order, or you choose another order that works well for them. Once I find the pictures, I'm going to save it again, and I'm going to make sure I use a different name, Storymap Dr. DeSoto. Click Save, and then I can access it anytime to share with students to edit or for my own purposes. Now I need to find icons for the problem and solution. Now for the problem, I think I'm just going to choose a face demonstrating that there is a problem, and then a face that demonstrates that there is a solution. I always need to remember to click outside of the red boxes. And as always, I need to save it again just to make sure that it saved correctly. Now I'm just going to save this over what I've already saved. I'm going to click yes, I want to replace that file. Now you've learned how to create your very own Kidspiration story map, and you've even learned how to use some of the fun stamps and other things that Kidspiration has to offer. Enjoy!